Greetings, friends. Reverend Stephen here, speaking to you from the sanctuary of St. Matthew Wesley United Church in North Sydney, Nova Scotia, with a message for Sunday, June 20th, 2021, the fourth Sunday in the Pentecost season. We are delighted to report that we will be back to worshiping in person here in the sanctuary beginning Sunday, July 4th, at our usual summer hour of 10 a.m. We are also planning to celebrate our anniversary on July 18th, including the Sacrament of Holy Communion. The church will be closed for the month of August, resuming fall worship beginning Labor Day weekend, September 5th at 11 a.m. Thank you for participating in our virtual worship experience over these past number of weeks. As we gather this morning, let's bow in prayer. Loving and generous God, in these words, may we find your word of abundant life through Jesus Christ, our Lord, Savior, and friend. Amen. Friends, as we approach the end of the pandemic, we are starting to pay more attention to other news, including the big issues that demanded the world's attention before COVID came along. One of these issues is climate change. The urgency to address this serious threat to the planet was not lessened by the pandemic, even if some of the factors contributing to global warming were slowed a bit by reduced industrial activity. The Earth is still getting warmer than it should be because of human activity, and we are still seeing the consequences. Last week, for example, the National Hurricane Center identified a tropical storm forming down south and moving on the usual path up the east coast toward Atlantic Canada. That storm is named Bill, making it the second named storm for 2021. Apparently there was a storm named Anna, but it didn't make much of an impression. I'd not heard a thing about it. Indeed, Bill looks like it will be little more than heavy rain way out to sea by the time it arrives in our region. That's good news, but still cause for concern that these disturbances are coming relatively early in the season. Next up, Claudette, Danny, Elsa, Fred, and so on. But where and how serious these storms will be, there's no way to know. We can only get ready to get ready. As with the storms of nature, so with the storms of life. We know that as much as we'd enjoy a guarantee of smooth sailing every day, that's not reality. We're reminded of this in our scripture today for the fourth Pentecost Sunday. In the Old Testament reading from Samuel, the storm, as it were, is named Goliath, the fierce warrior leading the Philistines in battle against ancient Israel. So feared was Goliath that it looked like the Israelite army might have to surrender, as no soldier would step forward to face the giant. It is a favorite Sunday school story, but no less powerful for being that, as young David the shepherd boy steps up and, armed only with his slingshot, defeats Goliath. It is not, we know, that simple weapon that fells the giant, but David's great faith that if God is calling him to face the storm, God will carry him through it. It's this faith that Paul talks about in Corinthians when he tells the readers of that letter that every day is an opportunity to have faith in God's presence and power to save us. Certainly that faith was needed on a day described by Mark in his gospel, when Jesus and a few of his disciples were in a boat on the Sea of Galilee, when a sudden storm came up and threatened them. Now these disciples were veteran fishermen, so we can imagine it was quite a storm to upset them so, and that much more of a shock when Jesus, who was sleeping in the boat, woke up and stopped the storm with a simple command. "Who is this man?" they asked. But Jesus asked, "Where is your faith in God?" At this point, the disciples had heard Jesus speak of faith, but now they were shown what faith could accomplish. Once the shock of the miracle wore off, they were left to consider what faith could do. The Old Testament told them that faith could part the sea to escape enemies, that it could enable a boy to defeat a giant, and so much more. We are also left to contemplate what our faith can accomplish. Certainly, it can enable us to survive life's storms, but God's Spirit also provides the power to calm storms within ourselves, storms of fear, of doubt, of despair, and storms outside. The prime example is the pandemic itself. The third wave was devastating enough in Nova Scotia, taking lives and inflicting further damage on our economy. But it would have been so much worse without the faith we had in proven protocols, including vaccination, that turned the worst of the disease away. Because we cared about each other, we looked after each other. This faith, this care, this love must go on and grow after the pandemic is gone, because the storms are never far away. We need to have faith in God, faith in each other, faith in the love that makes life meaningful and that carries us forward. We hope that we find that faith in our community here at St. Matthew Wesley and in the power of our scripture to remind us that whatever storms life may bring, God is near and our faith can be powerful, not only to carry us through storms, but to calm storms in our lives and in the life of the world. Thanks be to God for the power of faith and for access through the Holy Spirit to God's care. Friends, let's bow together in prayer. Loving God, we thank you for the gift of faith, that knowledge that God is near, that God cares, and that God will carry us through not only life's storms, but give us the power to make sure that there are fewer storms, and that the power of storms is not the determining factor in our existence. We thank you that this pandemic time is coming to an end. We thank you for the faithfulness that has been shown by people as they have looked after each other by staying home, by washing hands, by wearing masks, by getting vaccinated, by understanding that we are all in this together. Help that lesson to carry forward past pandemic times to normal times. Help us to know that we are not islands unto ourselves, but we are all part of a community, and that if one suffers, all suffer. And if one prospers, all should prosper. Help us from our prosperity, from our faith, from your grace, to be a blessing to the world. Lord, hear the prayer that has been spoken, the prayers and the needs of each life, and the prayer you taught us to say together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Thank you, friends, for taking time to participate in this worship service. We will have one more virtual time together, and then, as we noted at the beginning, we will be back in our sanctuary for the month of July. We look forward to that time and to being together this way again next week. Until that time, take care and God bless. Bye for now.